Welcome to the Sunday edition of Doc Confer. Yes. Normally, Doc Confer happens on a Saturday, but today is a special Sunday edition.
And on Sunday because you were speaking at the UBC.
Yes, I was speaking at UBC on yesterday, so we had to do it on Sunday. And today's also the Grey Cup edition, and that's why there's not many people here.
Oh my God, I forgot the game.
You forgot about the game. Yeah, the Grey Cup.
For the Children's Football League, yeah.
For the people who, for American readers who do not know what the Grey Cup is, perhaps you can explain what the Grey Cup is.
It's the prize for the winner of the Children's Football League, the CFL.
When the CFL, only, the Children's Football
League.
There's
only like, what, eight teams and six of them make the playoffs?
Eight teams, six make
the playoffs. You just kind of pass it around each year.
And so they have names like Lions and Argos.
Well, they were two Rough Riders for a while.
Rough Riders, yes.
The Ottawa Rough Riders against the Saskatchewan Rough Riders.
Yeah, exactly.
Yes, well, there you go.
When there's eight teams, can you not come up with another name?
Yeah. Well, obviously, we don't really care that much about football. That's why we're here at Furrow.
I'd much rather be here.
Yeah, then. Yeah. I mean, where are they playing this year? Well, what city won the bid? Won the pleasure, honor.
Edmonton.
So they're playing football in freezing cold.
About minus six. But it's sunny. Sunny
and
at minus six.
Did they play outdoor? Do they play outdoors?
They're playing
outdoor and it's minus six.
And, well, it was minus 25 when they were practicing. And there was about 3 feet of snow on the field. That was their practice. They had
that
to shovel the
true,
field off.
True Canadian football.
That's a warm-up.
That is true Canadian football right there.
But in defense of the names, two Rough Riders teams, there was actually, they had different spellings for the Rough Riders. One had a capital R for the Riders, and the other didn't. So that's how they knew they were
two.
Wow.
Yeah.
Eight league team, two names the same.
Why is it called the Grey Cup?
Why is it called a Grey Cup?
I imagine there's some guy named Grey.
Is the cup gray? The cup not gray?
Yeah.
I've never seen the
cup.
It's silver, but it's all tarnished, gone gray.
It's cold. From the cold.
Anyways, it's a football, right?
Yeah, football.
Well, American football.
It's
Canadian football.
Because Canadian football is a little bit different than American football.
Yeah, Canadian football was 110 yards, right?
Yeah.
The field's bigger.
The ball's bigger as well.
The ball's bigger. They're in three downs.
The field is wider, too. The field is wider?
Yes. The field is wider. Yeah. The end zone's deeper.
Yeah. Wow. Everything's bigger.
Everything's bigger except for the teams and the audience.
The audience is not bigger.
Is it the less rough game than the American football?
Is it less rough?
No, it's the same. It's the same.
It's just a bigger feel. You get to run around more.
You get more offense because there's more ball.
Yeah, because the ball's bigger. Yeah, the field's bigger.
The field's bigger, so
it's
then
easier to get open. Then
that's right.
You have
that's
more
right.
space to run around.
And in the Americans, the American players are so much bigger, and the field is smaller, so they take up more space, and then it's just more. It's more crushing defense.
Is there like a bonus point in Canadian football when they make a touchdown? Do they get the
when you miss the field goal and you kick it out, you get a point because you can kick it hard. Like what kind of?
I don't like rules like that.
It's a loser point, really.
Yeah, it's like you missed, but we'll give you a point because you got to kick it really hard. Oh. Yeah, thanks.
Very strange.
Yeah. That's why I like the
There you go. That's the CFL. Look it up. CFL.ca. Do they have a website? Do they even have a website?
They write it out in the snow.
We're assuming it's CFL.ca. We'll take a wild guess at that. Anyway, it probably is. So check it out. You want to see what the bigger version of football looks like. Bigger in everything, but audience size.
Yeah, and money.
Every time I come to Happy Fur, I like to get a wonton. What is the media? A Chinese dish, and not Vietnamese, but, you know, Happy Fur makes good Chinese soup here. Mm-hmm. And we have.
Let's see if this.
Oh, there. Stacy has the salad roll.
It's
shrimp, vermicelli, and it's wrapped in a condom. Michael, I dare you to eat a chili pepper.
No.
Give it a try. Let's all eat one.
No.
Let's have a chili pepper challenge. Anybody game for a chili pepper challenge? We all take a bite on the count of three. Maybe we can convince Aaron to go for a chili pepper.
Aaron might do it.
We'll ask him when he comes back. I mean, those suckers are hot. Really hot.
It burns at both ends.
I can smell it.
You can smell it, right? Yeah. It's hot. We all ate a hot chili pepper. Now it's your turn.
I think you guys are messing with me.
No. Look, there was a whole bunch of it. You need to try it because we all like, one, two, three, let's all go. So We want to film you doing it now. We got everyone else.
I want to see the film of you guys doing it.
We need to see you do it first.
Man. Eating it, so we didn't have a film.
Yeah, I was like, go for it. I like it. Yeah. Tell us you like it, Chef.
Oh man, it's pretty hot.
Compared to say a jalapeno, what do you think? Hottest? Not as hot?
Oh, give me a second here. Just so you know,
that's a Thai chili pepper.
Just so you know, I know you guys are all full of shit. You guys did not eat a pepper, did you?
Yes, we did. Well, you'll see it when you see the video.
Oh, God. No, it's compared to jalapeno, it's hotter.
It's hotter than jalapeno. It's a Thai chili pepper. Yeah, it's hotter.
Oh, God.
You're feeling it now, aren't
you? What do you do to stop it?
You're starting to turn red. Give him some milk. Milk works good, I heard.
Yogurt.
Well, yogurt. Yeah, yogurt will do it.
The oils, it's called capsicum.
It's your tongue, right?
Yeah, see, it's not water soluble, so that's why I say water doesn't help.
Yeah, yogurt.
Water makes it worse.
Bread will work good. Bread will absorb it.
Well, alcohol actually dissolves it. Sugar dissolves it as well.
How about bread? I find bread works good.
Yeah, I need some vodka or something right now.
Yeah, that sounds brilliant, actually. Alcohol.
Alcohol and hot.
My mouth is burning. Give me some vodka.
There you go.
Oh, man. Yeah.
Now you can enjoy your food.
Screw you guys.
Hey guys, the gadget of the week is this sleeve for the MacBook Air. Custom fitted for the MacBook. It's also TSA friendly. You don't have to take it out when you go through checkpoint security. And you know, for those TSA officer who can't read or doesn't know what it is, here it is. In case you MacBook Air. Tells you what it is, even says, let it tell you what's inside, aluminum alloy. But supposedly, you do this, you don't have to take it out of the bag, but you know, if they can still ask you to. What makes this thing unique? Zipper pouch, but to be sure the zipper doesn't damage the beautiful skin of the MacBook. It has an inner lining sleeve to make sure the zipper stays where it is and doesn't scratch your MacBook Air. Offers a really good protection, but still a little thin. I would still be careful with it. I mean, it'll protect it from normal stuff, but a big hit would still probably put a dent in it, but better than nothing. I got this at Amazon. I believe it was only $20, so really good price. There you go. Tucano, second skin for the Apple MacBook Air.